Not long ago, ChargerLAB did a charging compatibility 100 test video for ROG Ally, and recently we got a ROG 65W gaming charger dock, which is the official accessory for the ROG Ally. It can not only support charging, but also put your game on a larger display. So let's see how can we use it and test its charging performance. Except for the charger dock, it also comes with a dual USB-C cable. The charger dock is made of pure black, fire-retardant PC material with a matte surface. The ROG and its logo are on two sides. It has a foldable fronts, and the upper panel has an HDMI 2.0, a USB-A 2.0, and a USB-C port. All specs info are on the side. White list AC65-03. It supports input of 120V, 50 or 60 Hz, 1.5A. The maximum output of USB-C and USB-A can reach 65W and 5W, and the maximum power of dual ports can reach 65W. The size of this charger is about 49x68x33mm, and it weighs about 148 grams. It's smaller than the Apple 67W charger. The 2m dual USB-C cable adopts a nylon braided design. The 4K and DP mean it can support up to 4K video via DP standard. It adopts a full pin design, but does not have any micro chip. The ChargerLAB Power ZKM003C shows that the USB-C supports PD3.0, PPS, QC5 protocols. It has 5 fixed videos of 5V, 9V, 12V, 50V 3A, 20V 3.25A, and a set of PPS. But the USB-A only supports the DCP protocol. Now let's see how can we use it. You can play your game on a larger display through this charger dock while charging the ROG Ally at an output power of over 60W. With the built-in Windows 11, it can even turn your ROG Ally into a Windows PC. After connecting external peripherals such as keyboard and mouse through the USB-A, you can control the PC easily. It can also connect to the iPhone 15 series, USB-C iPad, laptops, and run them on a larger display. Since the USB-A we mentioned only supports USB 2.0, its transfer speed is not that fast. In addition, it can also trigger the TV mode of the Switch after updating the latest BIOS, which is convenient for Switch users. Now let's check its charging compatibility, starting with USB-C. It can support up to 65W PD and 3A PPS. So there is no compatibility issue when charging phones, tablets, laptops, and handheld game console. Moving to the USB-A, we noticed that the charging power of most devices is around 5W. Next, we use it to fully charge the iPhone 15 Pro. The voltage stays at 9V first, and the charging curve can be divided into 5 parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 20W for the first 18 minutes, then the power gradually drops to 60W, 11W, and 6.5W in turn. After the 46 minutes, the voltage dropped from 9V to 5V. The final part begins at 1 hour and 7 minutes, and the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 1 hour and 37 minutes to be fully charged. We plot it into another curve to see how fast it can be. It can charge the iPhone 15 Pro to 50% in 24 minutes, and it can reach 80% in 15 minutes, 100% in 1 hour and 37 minutes. The charging time is normal for the iPhone 15 Pro. Next, we'll use it to fully charge the 15-inch MacBook Air. The voltage is always around 20V. The charging curve can be divided into 4 parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 63W for the first 41 minutes. Then the power gradually drops to 50W and 33W in turn. The final part begins at 1 hour and 17 minutes, and the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 1 hour and 57 minutes to be fully charged. We also plot it into another curve to see how fast it can be. It can charge the 15-inch MacBook Air to 50% in 35 minutes, and it can reach 80% in 1 hour and 4 minutes, 100% in 1 hour and 57 minutes. Then let's take a look at a standby power test. The standby power consumption at 220V 50Hz is 0.085W and 0.067 watts at 110 volts 6 tests, which is about 0.745 and 0.587 kilowatt hour in 1 year, respectively. No more than 1 kilowatt hour per year can make you forget it's still on the socket. Next is the conversion efficiency test. The conversion efficiency varies from 77.64% to 89.36% at 220 volts 50 hertz. And the conversion efficiency varies from 78.13% to 89.04% at 110 volts 60 hertz. The conversion efficiency of this charger is close to 90%, except at 5 volts 3 amp. Now let's do the ripple test. The lower ripple means better quality. Firstly, let's check out its ripple without load. When the output is 9 volts 0 amp, the lowest ripple is 20 millivolts peak to peak. It also reaches 22.4 millivolts peak to peak when the output is 12 volts 0 amp. The ripples are relatively higher at 33.6 millivolts peak to peak when the output is 5 volts 0 amp. And it also reaches 32.8 millivolts peak to peak when the output is 20 volts 0 amp. Then move to the ripple test when loaded. The ripple decreases as the voltage and current decrease. When the output is 5 volts 3 amp, the lowest ripples are around 21.6 and 24 millivolts peak to peak. And when the output is 20 volts 3.25 amp, the highest ripples are around 33.6 and 38.4 millivolts peak to peak. Its ripple will not exceed 40 millivolts peak to peak under different outputs and voltages. So its performance is excellent. We put the charger into a 25 degrees Celsius thermal tank throughout the test, and recorded the highest temperature on the front and back after charging at 65 watts for an hour. Under 220 volts 50 hertz, the highest temperature on the front is 61.5 degrees Celsius, and the back is 66.5 degrees Celsius. Moving on to the 110 volts 60 hertz. The maximum temperature on the front is 72.8 degrees Celsius, and the back is 70 degrees Celsius. As we can see from this bar chart, the maximum temperature under 110 volts 60 Hz is very close to the upper limit of 77 degrees Celsius, but it still complies with the IEC 62368 standard. And the maximum temperatures under 220 volts 50 Hz are slightly lower. Well, that will be all the tests for this charger dock. What impressed us was the excellent conversion efficiency and ripple performance, but its temperature control is not good enough. It not only allows you to quickly charge your ROG Ally, but you can also play games on a larger display, just like the Switch's TV mode. So if you are tired of the small display and want to get a better gaming experience, it is a smart choice. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!